Hey everybody, and welcome to our live stream. Thank you so much for being here. I still see there's some people coming in both on Facebook and on YouTube, and again, we appreciate you being here. I'm going to bring in a couple of guests here. These aren't guests at all. These are GCB members. I got Ray and Chris here with me. James is watching but not able to join us, and Taylor, I'm very jealous, is in a cabin in the middle of nowhere in the woods of North Georgia, which I was too. But anyway, thank you all for being here. I wanted to, before we roll the video, we recorded this concert about 10 days ago, I guess, on the 13th of November. We did it at the Brickyard Recording Studio. It's where we recorded our album about a year and a half ago. And the reason we did it is, well, the pandemic really slowed us down. We played our last show in front of people in late February of 2020. At that time, we had a bunch more shows booked. We had Easter booked. We had a bunch going on. And everything, just like everywhere else, abruptly halted. And we didn't really get together because our rehearsal space was on lockdown. We were all on lockdown. We live in different places. So we didn't get together for a while. We finally reconvened just this past July at Chris's house and got right back on our rehearsal schedule. And if you all remember, at that time, we really thought the whole pandemic was really winding down. And we were very optimistic. We thought, oh, we're going to book concerts again. And we started making a plan for that. We put this show together. And then the Delta variant hit. And it's almost like it all happened over again. So we didn't really shut down. Fortunately, we were able to keep rehearsing. And we kept trying to make plans about maybe this will get better. And maybe we can play a concert sometime. And finally, we said, why don't we just do a live stream concert? And the original intent was to maybe even present it where we rehearse, which is a church in Covington, Georgia. And we would have a video and an audio crew come by and film the whole thing. And then we could share it with you like this. After talking with Jason over at the Brickyard, he said, you know, it might be a better idea to just come to the studio. We can get better sound. We can get better video. And so that's what we've got for you here tonight. This is our fall concert. We're not quite in our holiday mode yet. We are in real life, but this concert was the last of our pre-holiday stuff. So I'm going to let it roll here in just a second, but I do want to let you know, you might have seen it in the comments on both Facebook and in the description on YouTube. This concert's totally free, and we're so happy that all of you are here and joining us, and it's going to stick around for a little while online, so you'll be able to re-access it, or some of you might be watching this now who weren't able to join us live. But, you know, a regular concert is not without its costs, and this one certainly wasn't either. There's a bit more of a cost when it came to hiring studio space and recording engineers and a video crew. So we are taking donations tonight. We're taking those via PayPal and through our Venmo account. You're going to see links for those throughout the entire video. That's totally voluntary. If you're able to give, we really, really appreciate it. It helps us offset the cost of putting this concert on. If you need a suggested amount, I would just say, you know, whatever you would normally pay to go to a live show. But those donations are very much appreciated, and again, are voluntary, but we do appreciate anything you can give. Okay, so the last thing I'm going to say before we get going here is the comments are live, and I see some of them are coming through already. Please feel free to comment away. I might throw a couple up on the screen while we watch if we feel like they're really great. So no mean comments, please. We have thin skin. I'm just kidding. And if you have questions for us, you're going to hear a lot of this music that we're presenting tonight, we wrote. If you have questions about that process or how we put things together or just about anything, we might do a little bit of a Q&A at the intermission. That's just kind of dependent on if there are questions there to be answered. But we will take a little bit of an intermission, a little bit of a break. And like I said, if there's some questions to answer, we'll do it. Okay, without further ado, I'm going to let this roll and I'm going to get our faces off the screen for a little bit. Here we go.
Thank you.
Hey, this is not intermission, but I thought I'd just jump on and say a few things. If you've been to a Gate City Brass show, you know that I talk a little bit between the tunes and just give some background on them. I did put a graphic up there not too long ago just to let you know that, in lieu of that, for the most part, there are program notes for every piece on this concert at gatecitybrass.com. Go to the music tab and look at recordings, and this is starting right at the top of that page. But I just did want to give a few notes about the two pieces that you just heard. I know there's been four, but they really come from two pieces. We started the concert with Gate City Fanfare. That was written by our very own Taylor Helms. It's a fanfare he had mostly worked out before he joined the group, but we read it when he came into the group and loved it so much, and he liked it for quintet, so he renamed it and named it after us. And so we've been starting just about every show since with that fanfare. And then the last three that you just heard were all movements from one larger piece called Five Sea Shanties. Those were written by a composer named Raymond David Burkhart. He actually just passed away not too long ago, just a couple months ago, or I guess earlier this year. You might remember, if you've been following Gate City Brass, that we funded our first album through a Kickstarter campaign. And it wasn't the first time I'd used Kickstarter. I had been on Kickstarter before that and actually had contributed to Mr. Burkhart's Kickstarter to have that piece written. And then I received it and I sort of put it away because at the time I still lived in North Carolina. I was coaching a brass quintet, a college level quintet that wasn't really ready to play it. And I sort of forgot about it. And then when we put Gate City Brass together, we pulled it back out and I was kind of blown away. I thought, oh, this is better than I thought it was. So that's been a regular staple of our concerts as well. There are five movements to it, but we just played three there. So anyway, I just thought I'd give you those notes. Again, feel free to comment, ask questions if you want. We're going to continue the concert right now. Thank you. pause a little early. Sorry. You're going to hear some ring after we start it back up. Hey, we only have one more left on this half before we take just a slight intermission. And so I wanted to talk just about a few things that we played there that I didn't address before.
I think we need to address, where does Ray go?
I don't know. He disappeared. He was hanging out with us, and then I guess he decided not to like us anymore, so he left. That's okay. He can come back if he wants. No, I think he was having a software issue, so he is watching from home. So yeah, after the sea shanties, you heard Souvenir de Puerto Rico. That was a piece written by Louis Moreau Gottschalk, and it's a kind of a favorite composer of the group. We've each of us have arranged. Well, we've arranged a couple pieces by Gottschalk for the group. That's the only one on tonight's concert. Great arrangement by Taylor to take that piano piece and make it really, really work for the quintet. And then you just heard St. Louis Blues. This is another one that's been in our rotation for a little while. We have a little bit of fun with that. Everybody gets featured just a little bit. But we're going to close out this half. There's a whole other half after this. We're going to close out this half with a piece of music that actually a lot of quintets are playing right now. We've been playing it for a little while. And it's written by a young composer named Kevin McKee. This piece of music is called Escape. It was the first, I believe it's the first piece of music that he had published. And he wrote it when he was still a master's student and premiered it as part of his master's recital. And it's a really dramatic piece. It really shows off some of the louder, faster parts of our group. It's written in a very cinematic style, and it's supposed to be depicting a dramatic descent back down the Castle Crags rock formation in California on the onset of a pretty violent storm. So yeah, we're going to take a look at some comments after this one. And if you have any questions that we can answer, we're going to answer those live. And then we're probably just going to let this one breathe for just a minute or two. We'll put up the stream will start soon again graphic at the end of this one if there's not any questions to answer before we start the second half. So please enjoy. Oh, and I didn't mention this before, and I should have, and I know that we're halfway through the concert. Maybe it's too late. I should have said this at the very beginning. If you're able to listen on headphones or on really good speakers, you probably get a little bit better audio quality. I think it's probably coming through pretty great no matter how you're listening to it, but I'm listening on headphones and it sounds fantastic. Okay, so here's Escape. This closes out our first half, and we'll be back with the second half just after that. Thank you. Paused it right at the beginning of a high five. So here we're at intermission. I'm going to take the video down just for a second and just kind of talk about a couple things. Might read a couple comments. I'm seeing a lot of comments on Facebook, and seems like we have a little bit of a Chris Savage fan club here. Colton Strawn and Familia watching from Charlotte, North Carolina. But then it says, go Canes, go dogs. Canes being the mascot of Chris's school where he teaches. Elizabeth watching from Monticello. That's probably a Savage fan. Maybe a Ray fan too, though, right? Then there's lots of Savage, I see you. One of those trumpet players is a Savage. You know, there's other people in the quintet too. So, oh, but Aaron says,
they don't have my name.
Great. Well, it's just your name. That's what it is. Aaron says, sounding great. Sad your trombone player ducked from the live stream. He's a handsome fella. I don't know about that, Aaron. Oh, that's Ray's wife. Oh, yes, you're right. Chris Savage Fan Club. Yeah, that's what I said. Some other people on there, too. Again, we appreciate all of you being here. Thanks for joining us on this live stream. We've got another half to go. But I do just want to mention one more time, we are taking donations for this free concert. It's 100% free. But if you are able, we really appreciate your donations. Helps us offset the cost of doing this. We had a blast making this, and we're hoping to use some of this video and put it up on our YouTube channel and on our website, and maybe chop it up a little bit and use some clips here and there. But, you know, we're really excited to be sharing it with you here tonight. One little anecdote I'll tell you about the creation process here that maybe I could have mentioned earlier is, and I don't think any of us expected it, but we've been working towards putting the stream together. Our rehearsals have basically been running the program in order and just checking spots. And a lot of this is material that we have played in front of audiences before. It's just been a while. But like I said, when we sat down in the studio, it was almost 21 months to the day since the group had played in front of an audience. And I guess we just weren't really thinking about that because, you know, we're in the Brickyard and the camera crew that was there, I think they used 7 cameras. So they're kind of all over the place and there's lights everywhere and we've got our microphone set up. And, you know, we did a lot of sound check for, I don't know, a couple of hours before we actually started rolling on the actual performance. And we played the first one and we got done and, you know, the cameras cut or, you know, we edited that part out all the time in between, but we kind of all looked at each other And we had those nerves like we were playing in front of people. And did you think that too?
Oh
Yeah,
yeah,
I
James
mean,
and I looked at one another and said that, yeah.
yeah, it was really strange because, I mean, we weren't really playing for people other than the four or five guys who were there on the crew. But you would have thought we'd have been playing for a packed house because we all got done. We're a little bit like, ooh. And then pretty soon we settled into that, and it was kind of that classic energy that I think the group feeds off of, playing in front of people. But yeah, I didn't expect that, being that there wasn't actually an audience except for this online audience that we knew was coming. But I just thought that was kind of an interesting, unexpected effect that happened. But yeah, so I think I was mentioning that we're taking donations, but I didn't mention where. Again, those are at paypal.me/GateCityBrass, or you can go, if you have the Venmo app, we are just at Gate City Brass, all one word, on those. And anything that you can give, we really, really appreciate. This concert is going to stick around on our social channels for just a bit, and so maybe there will be people who are watching it later who those links are still active. Again, if you want full program notes for the performances, they're at gatecitybrass.com, and then you hit the music tab and go to recordings. So there's no Christmas or holiday music on this particular concert, but that is the exact season that we find ourselves moving into. In fact, just 2 days after we recorded this, we did play for part of Brenau University's holiday concert. I teach at Brenau, and we played a small little set of five of our Christmas tunes, most of them from the album that we recorded a couple years ago. And after tonight, we are 100% in that mode of Christmas performances. You can check those out at gatecitybrass.com as well. Hit the calendar tab. Especially if you're in the Atlanta area, we have a handful of performances booked. Some of those are with other groups. On December 5th, we're playing in Noonan with the Masterworks Chorale. You might have seen that listed in the AJC this last weekend. And then we're playing with Oak Grove United Methodist Church's choirs and congregation on December 11th and 12th. But outside of that, we have a handful of Gate City Brass Christmas concerts. That's just us, the concerts we put on, somewhat like this, except live and in person. And it's all Christmas and holiday music. It's a mixture of some stock arrangements and then arrangements written by members of the quintet. Chris and I, and Taylor as well, who's joining us from his cabin vacation spot. We wrote 11 of the 12 tunes on that album, and we play those very often in concerts as well. So yeah, if you check out gatecitybrass.com and hit calendar tab, especially if you're in the Atlanta area. We also have one in Athens coming up. We just actually finalized that today, so I'll be posting details about that as well. The dates are December 9th and 20th in Atlanta, December 21st in Athens. If you're at all in the area, check those out. Tickets are available at eventbrite.com. Just search for Gate City Brass Christmas Concert. I think that's all I got to say. I'll probably hear sick of hearing my voice already. Did I forget anything there, Chris?
No, I'm thinking your voice too, but
Oh, you're already sick of my voice. Okay. Well, then, without further ado, let's get to the second half of this concert. Thanks again for being here. I probably won't say a whole lot in this half, but I don't promise. I might butt in once or twice more. Here we go. All right, enjoy the second half.
high five.
Thank you. right. Thought I'd jump in a little bit there. That's a great tune. Interesting arrangement of Down by the Riverside. It's fairly new to the quintet. We picked that up when we got back together, just this past summer. And it's by an arranger we've already played some arrangements of, Gary Slekta. But really interesting treatment of the melody, especially in that middle section there before it gets to the big band section. Some of the other tunes that we just heard since I last spoke, going backwards from Down by the Riverside, was Killer Tango. If you're a fan of the Canadian Brass, you might recognize that as a tune that they have played on some of their albums. And it was written by the composer Sonny Kompanek. Kompanek is kind of a film composer, but wrote that great tango, and it sits really well in the brass. So these next two tunes that are coming up were arranged by Taylor. Taylor originally kind of thought about these as being part of a suite, but I think he's kind of changed tack on that, and these two just sort of stand alone, or they might end up as a suite later on down the road. The tunes are Wayfaring Stranger, which is set in kind of a somber tone, and the next one after that is House of the Rising Sun. And that tune he's going to set in kind of a slow blues before it moves into a tango. So we just finished a tango, and here you'll hear a little bit of another one here at the end of House of the Rising Sun. I'm playing flugelhorn on both of these, but both of them also feature pretty much everybody else in the quintet. After that, you're going to hear an arrangement of Chicago. There are a couple Chicago tunes. Both were made really famous by Frank Sinatra, but if I say Chicago and you think Frank Sinatra, you might be thinking of the later one, which was My Kind of Town. This is an earlier tune, and again by Fred Fisher. And then I'll jump in after that before we play the last tune just to kind of wrap up the evening. But enjoy these next two arrangements by Taylor and then Chicago after that.
Thank you.
Everybody, we're already at the end. Kind of flew by. I think I'm used to playing this many tunes in a live concert where I just talk too much at the live concert, right? Or tell many corny jokes. Yeah, I tell a lot of corny jokes. But you know, Facebook Live, YouTube Live's not worth it because I can't hear you laugh. Maybe it's because you're laughing. There it is. Well, I did want to just jump in here right before we play the last tune to thank you all for coming, for spending an hour of a Tuesday evening with us in what I'm sure is a busy week as everybody's getting ready for the Thanksgiving holiday. Means a lot to us that you would take that time to come and check out some brass quintet music. We are so excited to be playing in front of live audiences again. It's been way too long, and we just thought this would be a really great way to catapult into that. Like I said before, we are getting ready for a pretty busy December schedule. Hopefully you can come check us out live. If not, hopefully we can get some video or at least some clips of some of those performances up for some of you. Just one last big thanks to everybody who's already hit those donation links. Those donations are so appreciated. Definitely help us offset some of the costs of putting a performance like this together. And so we really, really, really appreciate that. You can see those at the bottom in this last tune if you haven't had a chance yet. But we're on both Venmo and PayPal. So this last tune to close out the concert is brand new. In fact, Chris can remind me, I think we've only had it in rotation for rehearsals even for 2 or 3 weeks here.
Yeah,
because we wrote it. I'm just gonna, I think it's got some clicking on Chris, so mute him here real quick. You might have noticed that the concert features a couple cities. We played the St. Louis Blues in the first half. We started the second half with San Francisco, the theme from San Francisco. And then you just heard Chicago. And just as we were rehearsing, we thought, well, it's too bad we don't have something for our home city of Atlanta or our home state of Georgia. And I don't know why, honestly, it took us so long. I'm going to bring Chris back in here. I don't know why it took us so long to figure it out, but Chris comes to me one day and says, why don't we just write Georgia on my mind? Well, duh. And so we actually collaborated on that. It's the first time we collaborated on an arrangement. I say collaborated because Chris is very, very generous. He actually wrote most of it. He said, well, why don't we collaborate on it maybe? And I said, yeah, I mean, sure, get a start on it. So he wrote pretty much the whole thing and sent it to me, and I wrote the ending, and I threw in a couple little things into the arrangement, and I think we both made a few tweaks. But we really
loved it.
It went back and forth a few times. But wow, we really love this arrangement, and I think it's going to become kind of a staple of Gate City Brass concerts. Maybe not in the month of December, because those are holiday concerts and performances. But yeah, I think you could maybe expect to hear this to close out concerts for the foreseeable future, again, except for December. So I hope you enjoy to close out tonight our arrangement of Georgia on My Mind. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Hey, everybody, that's the end of the show. Again, thank you all so much for coming. Thanks for your comments. Thanks for your interaction. Thanks for your support. For everybody who gave donations, we thank you so much. So helpful in offsetting the cost to produce this and to, catapult us into the next thing. So we're on to December now. If you're in the Atlanta or Athens areas, we've got shows coming your way. Check us out. GateCityBrass.com, go to the calendar tab. We try to update that as often as possible. That's it. On behalf of everybody, Chris is already here, but on behalf of Ray and Taylor and James, we just thank you from the bottom of our hearts. Thank you so much.
Thanks.